Next question. It's not okay to talk about sex. This is just also a lie. In fact, the first conversation that God ever had with man involved sex. Genesis, look at it. The first conversation God ever had with Adam and Eve involved sex. It also knit together our inherent value as image-bearing creations of God. He said, be fruitful, be productive, be constructive, move in purpose, cultivate the land, rule over my creations. And then he said, and multiply. So God knit together our value as the epitome of his work and our sexual instruction of multiply. He spoke into sex right from the beginning. And he wove those two beautiful things together. Now, what we struggle with is we strip those things two apart. And then sexual sin often becomes this struggle to find our identity, to find our worth, to be loved, to feel seen, to feel accepted and known. Man, God says, no, I spoke from it right at the beginning. And all through the holy word of God, he speaks about sex. He uses Rahab the prostitute in the lineage of Jesus Christ. He sits at the well with the Samaritan woman, the whore, with a list a mile long, and he offers her living water that she would never thirst again. He stands in front of the adulteress, and he doesn't cast a first stone. His great love and mercy compels her to go and sin no more. So I see a God that's quite comfortable with talking about sex. We see kingdoms rise and fall through the word of God around issues and topics of sex. He speaks into it, and so to talk about it is to look more like the creator who made it. So I talk about sex all day long. I make my family uncomfortable. I make everybody uncomfortable, but it shouldn't be taboo. It's a gift from God. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you want to learn more about marriage and sexuality, jump over to focusonthefamily.com. And if you want to dive into sex, Jesus, and the conversations a church forgot, click this link right here. Thanks.